All right, what's up, people? Just doing a real quick video on this Ferrum Forge Design Mashtrap Buck. They've been shipping all this week. I got mine, I think, Monday or Tuesday, so I've had it 3-4 days. I'm not going to do the specs or anything. I'm just kind of doing this video because most people should be getting theirs shortly, and I figure some will be popping up on the secondary market, so if you're interested in picking one up on the secondary, maybe you'll have a little bit better idea about the knife. So I'm not going to do the specs size-wise, just kind of an overview. Here's a Spyderco Native just for size comparison. As you can see, it's a decent bit longer than it, but it is a lot skinnier in the handle. The blade does look a lot wider than it, but it's really not. The Native, in its widest point, is actually wider than the Buck in its widest point. So, but it is probably a quarter inch shorter or something like that. So anyway. Blade steel's S35VN. It's obviously a titanium frame lock flipper, titanium backspacer, pocket clip, has a steel lock bar insert. Blade is whatever this is, a cleavery Warncliffe thing, I don't know, whatever you want to classify it as. So anyway, getting into the knife. This knife was about $115, I think, which is, honestly, they did a great job for the price. It's really a good knife for the price. Getting into, first off, I'll just kind of start on lockup. The lockup is totally secure. I spine whacked this knife a few times. When I say spine whack, I didn't fucking hammer on it. I just, did a little bit of that on the back of I have a wooden desk at work. And, it didn't move, didn't do anything, didn't fail. There's no play up or down. Locks up solid. It's my kid in the background. I have no time to do these videos without them being around, so you might hear a little noise. So lockup's totally secure, solid. Engagement is, kind of like right where you want it, not too early, not too late. Action is smooth, good deployment. The tent's nice and solid, flips well. As far as the action goes, there's two things I'll hit it on, which every once in a while I'll get it where I'll get that like kind of slip off. The knife is kind of very slender in the handles, and sometimes I'll get too much pressure on that lock bar depending on how I hold it. Sometimes like I'll try to do it and I can't even do it, but the other times I'm just flicking it and I can get it to, I get that pressure on, there it is right there. I got it because I'm pushing really hard and paying attention, but sometimes I'll slip off and it kind of is a little bit annoying. So there's that part, and then this thumb hole here, I really can't, consistently open this with the thumb, just my thumb, because like I said, it's putting the pressure right on the lock bar. I can spidey flick it consistently, so, and then if you were wanting to open it a little bit more discreetly, I can, kind of pinch it open and then just roll it, so. But as far as what it's designed to do, be a flipper, it works perfectly. The action's, it's not fall down shut. It's not really broken in that well, and I haven't oiled this knife at all. It is how it came. And I've actually liked the action. It's nice and like hydraulic. I don't really like the fall drop. I like having to do this a little bit. When they fall down and shit, I always end up cutting myself a little bit, hit the thumb every once in a while. So I actually prefer that type of action right there anyway. So I'm totally fine with that. It's nice, smooth, works well. Since I'm opening and shut this, this knife came perfectly centered. See there? Like I said, good action. They did a lot of things right on this that you usually don't see on a $115 titanium frame lock with S30V. Like, usually you're lacking somewhere. And, like, the little thing is, like I said, on that thumb hole, if you can see in there, the hole's perfectly chamfered, even though you can't use it for the thumb that well for a spidey flick. They did chamfer it well. Top of the blade is chamfered. Inside the finger troll is chamfered. And even on here, it's chamfered too. It doesn't look like it. It's obviously not as chamfered as much as it is over here, but it's still chamfered where it's not crazy sharp or anything like that. The inside of the lock bar right there is chamfered. So when you, if you like to play and flick with your knives or even just normal use, it doesn't hurt your finger or anything like that. So those little details really, like I said, when you usually get a little cheaper of a frame lock and it comes with the quality materials, you might see a little bit of hit or miss in those type of areas, and they did not miss. For $115, I think they did a pretty damn good job as far as that type of shit's concerned. The blade finish, you know, it is what it is. It's a machine, like high satin, you know, fingerprint magnet. And, you know, it don't look bad, but it is what it is. So, the pocket clip, that's a negative of this knife. This knife is really slender. The ergonomics of this knife aren't bad, but the handle, to be honest, I like them a little bit wider. It's just, it's not that it's uncomfortable, but it's not as comfortable if it were just a little bit wider for me at least. I have used this to cut, not a ton of shit, but typically when I get a new knife, I'll take some cardboard, I cut up, you know, some big squares and put about four pieces together. That way it's a little bit tougher to cut through. You can see how well, if the knife slices well, if it doesn't slice well, and then it's usually a little tougher to get through it, and then you can see if there's a little bit of hot spot. And I will say this pocket clip is a little bit of a hot spot. Not deal breaker hot spot to where it's like really painful or that, but if you're doing some long cutting with this or some tougher cutting, you will feel that pocket clip. Like I said, not deal breaker, painful, terrible hot spot. Just you'll feel it when you're done. So like I said, don't quite think it's deal breaker painful enough to be called that, but you'll feel it. And choked up in the choil, knife's very comfortable. To be quite honest, I didn't try to like really do any tougher cuts with that or go through all that cardboard with that. I've done just some little shit that's, you know, really nothing. So it was fine cut up a vegetable. I forget the hell it was, but a cucumber, I think. So I'm really not going to, you know, feel anything for that. But pocket clip's a little bit of the negative. So honestly, I don't really like these milled pocket clips. I like spring clips because they're more comfortable in more situations, but it is what it is. So, but being that, for getting this knife coming perfectly centered, good action, for the most part, pretty ergonomic. And the blade is, you know, kind of thick stock. I think it's around 160 thou, but it is ground very thin behind the edge. This knife does slice very well. It's obviously not going to be a knife for everybody. It's got kind of a wonky blade shape, but it does slice very well, and it's very reasonably priced for the materials and how well it's finished. So, honestly, I think it's kind of a winner. If you're interested in one, I'd say pick one up. It's honestly, for the price tag, it's not a bad knife. It could definitely be, you know, could cost more. So, that's that. I like the knife. May not keep it forever. I honestly haven't been that big into flippers. I bought this back when they dropped or whatever. And quite frankly, the Native is my favorite pocket knife right now. I've been carrying mostly fixed blades and stuff that works. So, but I do like this knife. I'm just haven't been into flippers much lately. But I do think it's a good quality, you know, knife for the price. With some minor issues, but at that price point for the materials, I think they can be forgiven. So that's that, and I'm out.